Hey there, Andy Staines from Henshaw Electrical here. Just finishing our Sonos installation at our customer's house over in rural Dorset. So we've got the speakers wired. The speakers, as you can see, beautifully installed in the ceiling. Amplifiers being positioned. We've also fitted a bar, a sound bar, which is connected to the LC on the TV output, and that's paired up with our sub. We've got, in addition, the ceiling speakers that we had previously installed in the dining room. So I've got two here. We finished these about a couple of months ago now, and we've also got a pair of weatherproof speakers on the patio, which will provide some cracking barbecue tunes, I should imagine. And customers also started off with a couple of other Sonos products. So coming back into the kitchen, we've got a play one in here, and they may choose to reposition that once they decide how they want the setup to be. And in the living room, we've got another soundbar on the existing TV, another sub, and there's another play one over in the corner there. So, better check all of this works. So, got the Sonos app installed on the phone. So, once I've got that up and running, we can have a look at our different speakers, all selected. So we go to our volume, we'll start off with kitchen ceiling speakers. We've also got our play one in the kitchen. We got the TV room, so we'll bring that up. So we now got the sub, soundbar, and play one in the kitchen in the TV room. Let's just see, BBC 6, yes, quality music. We can then add in our TV in the kitchen. So let's bring that up. Ooh, starting to sound nice. Got that sub going on there, sounds cracking. And let's now add a dining room speakers. Now, where are we? Dining room. There it is. Wonderful. And last but not least, see if we can get our patio speakers up and running. And so once again, we just operate the volume button and we select patio speakers. There we go. Now we've also got group control. So we can control the levels everywhere. And as you can hear, that's pretty funky. And we can drop them all down together as well. I've also set up a few other groups. So I've set up just kitchen. We've literally just got this room. We've got kitchen and dining room. We've got kitchen, dining room, patio. And we've also then added on the TV, so we've got a whole house ground floor. Customers also going to be looking at installing further speakers in the rest of the patio area, down by their swimming pool, and in their, when they carry out refurbishment, the next stage of the refurb is going to be looking at conservatory and living room. So we'll continue to install, and they are such a good product. Sound quality is fantastic. Installation is really straightforward. It took a little bit getting my head around at first, but now another couple, and this one was really, really quick. Started it 2 o'clock, getting everything set up. It's 3 o'clock, so get everything up and running. Had time for a bit of lunch, and all the products all working together in the correct method. So the soundbar came with its own bracket. Just connects it onto the rear of the TV. Works really nicely. Got all our wiring tidied away. Nice neat installation. Still a little bit of work down here. I think the customer's going to put some furniture in here, maybe a shelf or a cabinet to hold the remainder of it, the bits and pieces. And as far as our products go, amplifiers are sited down here. So we've got 2 amplifiers. These are for our dining room and also for the patio. And then I've just finished the installation up in this loft void. We've got our amplifier for the kitchen speakers up in here, and as you can see, we set it up. We've got a whole load of extra sockets. We've got existing TV amp and lighting controls and junction boxes and what have you, but we've got some extra sockets and we've got plenty of space up there. So I think we might, when we do the expansion, we've got room to install the rest of our amps up here. Now, loft space. This loft space has got an insulated roof. It's a warm roof, effectively. Solitex has been installed between the joists, and that gives us it's less subject to solar radiation heating, and our amps should therefore shouldn't be too upset. But it's a great space, really useful, and this is one of the challenges on these sorts of installations, whether it's a smart home, whether it's home automation, heating controls, home audio. You need space, you need somewhere to put the products to keep them out of the way. Somewhere cool, somewhere accessible, somewhere you can get the wiring to, but somewhere that's kind of out of the way. The customer doesn't want to see all the guts, but we want to need to have a useful plant room that helps us do our work. So this little utility room, really great space, just been completely refurbished, tiled cabinets, lighting, smoke detectors, and obviously we've got the dining room here. We've got this cabinet which has given us the space to install amplifiers, broadband routers here, plus a switch to give us enough ports going out. We've got the DMX controllers and drivers for the in-ceiling LED lighting. We've also got a Hamilton Mercury system providing smart control of lighting. And these controls are all sited over in the kitchen. Over here, we've got our Hamilton Mercury. So we can turn the lights on and off, etc. from here. Various different scenes, options. And then we've got our LED lighting as well. Kitchen, patio, and shelves.
Smell of the ocean. The smell of the heather.
There we go. Great job, really enjoyed this one. Really nice to get it up and running and all finished in time for Christmas, so the customer can enjoy their home. Happy Christmas all.